Hey guys, what's going on? It's Phil here from TechSmart, and today we're going to be taking a look at the new features in iOS 8 Beta 2. So starting off, the podcast application is now going to be pre-installed, so if you didn't have it already, now you do. Next up, if you go ahead and pull down your Spotlight search, you'll notice that whatever your last search was is actually going to be highlighted in the text field. This way you can quickly just go ahead and start typing for a new query, or you can just go ahead and type on the cursor right here and you can continue typing in whatever you were searching for. Also, if you're in settings and you're down in a list somewhere, so just say we're down here and we click on mail, you can actually swipe back and it's going to keep your position. It's not going to auto-scroll all the way to the top like we are seeing with iOS 8 Beta 1. Next up, you can quickly add websites to your shared links, or you can also quickly add them to bookmarks. So within Safari, if you just press and hold on this little bookmark icon, you see add bookmark, add to reading list, and subscribe and shared links. So that right there is new, and now I've just subscribed to it. Now within iMessage, if you go ahead and open up, you'll notice that the camera and the microphone buttons are now gray instead of blue. You also have this option within iMessage to mark all messages as red. So if you click on edit and you see read all, that'll go ahead and mark all of your messages as red quickly for you. On the iPad, you're going to have predictive text. And now in the App Store, you're no longer going to have that little glitch where it was showing titles like Insta dot 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 and now actually just formats everything correctly. So that's a little bug fix that they fixed there. You have a raise to listen toggle within your settings. So if we go to settings here and we go down to iMessage, you have raise to listen. So you can disable that if you don't want that there, so you don't have to quickly send your little voice memos. Now you've also noticed I have Assistive Touch pulled up right here. If you click on Assistive Touch, you now have options for Control Center and Notification Center. Control Center will pop up right there. And Notification Center isn't working, but I mean it is there, so we know it's definitely going to be coming very soon. Now within Safari, you can double space to do periods again. So if we say hi, double space, a period is going to be up in there. Next up, when you restart your phone, it's not going to ask you to log into iCloud every time. It's just going to act like a normal phone. Also, auto brightness seems to have been working better now, so you're not having the whole glitchiness that we had before. And now, this is annoying and new, but if you type in a form box, basically it auto scrolls you to the top of the page. So if we go, I can try to pull up a form. We'll click on login. If I type here and then you see it auto jump me right up to the top. So it's a little bit annoying and definitely, I mean, hopefully they're going to fix that in beta 3. A really nice update they included was handoff now works within messages, which didn't work with beta 1. If you go back and watch our Yosemite video, you know that handoff and a lot of the features and continuity weren't working yet. So they're slowly starting to roll those in there and that's really nice to see. Now, this is just a known issue. Extensive console logging and NC launch stats may cause reduced battery life. So the workaround for this is if you actually launch Notification Center, then reboot your device. So the recently deleted album now states that the items will be erased 30 days after being marked for deletion. Just nice and helpful, just, you know, so people aren't going to be freaking out when everything's gone. Anyways, guys, that's really going to be it. So there's a few more features here and there. They're just really minor bug updates. We'll include a link in the description below for you to check out all of them. But that's really all the notable ones. And I mean, overall, it's running a little bit quicker. I may actually use this as my daily operating system. It seems to be more stable than beta 1. But overall, guys, that's it. That's iOS 8 beta 2. Be sure to check the link in the description below if you want to download iOS 8 beta. We actually have a website where you can go ahead and check it out, iosbetas.com. Anyways, guys, it's Phil from TechSmart. Leave us a comment below letting us know if you're using the betas. I'll see you guys in the next one. Later.